Game on the docket, 971, 972. JP Sears and the A's at plus 170. Ronel Blanco and the Astros at minus 200. Total of 8.5 flat across the board at minus 110. Blades of Glory, it might be on the Mount Rushmore of comedy movies. It's way up there. It's pretty damn funny. We're going to have to do a Mount Rushmore of comedy movies here shortly. But Corby, look, I wanted to take the Astros. I was really close to taking the Astros double result. But J.P. Sears isn't a can. Like, he has his moments where he looks pretty good. He's going six innings strong. Astros got off the schneid yesterday. The offense looked good yesterday. What do you like in this one, Houston, Oakland?
Yeah, I would kind of disagree on the fact that, like, I think J.P. Sears gets this nod of being good because he plays for the Athletics. Like, right now, at current form, I don't think J.P. Sears is actually that good. 44% hard hit rate, a 263 expected batting average, 17% strikeout rate. His stuff at times does work. I do agree with you there. And he is the light of a team that just doesn't have much light. They have looked better, but still don't think they are anything to compete with the Houston Astros. Ronel Blanco, 195 expected batting average, has looked good. And I, at the end of the day, trust this offense to score a lot more runs than I trust the Oakland Athletics. So at home, I take Houston, first five run line, minus 120. You can actually get minus 115 at BetUS now. This is the best price in market by a decent amount. I see a lot of sports books at minus 135 right now. So if you have BetUS, minus 115, we're going to lock in, for the sake of the show, minus 120. That double result's at plus 110 now. So you're seeing a pretty good price for a double result.
I'm going to take it. Where's the live button? I might be adding a couple of them. Let's live button that double result. I was really close on this one, and I wanted to hear you talk me into it. And I hope I didn't do this too early, because I like to hear B-Dub break down the pitchers and if I'm doing the right thing here. But I know Blanco's been good. I'm going to take that plus 110, though. You're getting that 30 cents, so I'm getting the differential that I want there. So I'll live betting the Astros double result. B-Dub, did I make a mistake here? What do you think? What is J.P. Sears? That's where it makes me nervous, is J.P. Sears.
Yeah, it shouldn't. Sears, okay. Corby made some good points on that. I have him in the model 9% worse than an average pitcher. I don't like Blanco. He's got some control issues. He's got some fly ball issues. And I have him rated actually worse than Sears. But really taking that into account, the Houston Astros offense is to me, underrated in the market. It's top three offenses with the Dodgers and the Braves. And it's pretty close, actually. It's a pretty close comparison if you look at it. And one of the things, I have the game price, just my pricing on it is minus 194. So it would indicate if value probably on Houston a little bit. One of the things I thought was really interesting, and I do this probably about middle of May. I'm a little bit early on it this year because I was excited to do it. But it's my bullpen three metric chart. And the three metrics I look at are expected strikeout percentage based on swinging strike percentage. There's an equation that you can use. Expected walk percentage based on balls divided by pitches. So pretty simple, but it allows me to get a little bit more into a pitch by pitch scenario. And there's pluses and minuses is about doing that, but the Astros bullpen collectively third in baseball with those three measures, and the final metric is hard hits per nine. But I use the expected walk percentage and the expected strikeout percentage to come up with a projected ERA, and Houston is number three in baseball, and I thought that was fairly interesting. So I don't really hate this bullpen. I mean, we talked about it yesterday. You talk about the Presley, the Abreu, and Hader there. They're all over 30% strikeout percentage from a more macro standpoint. And I think you get a huge advantage in the bullpen. And Oakland, they have Mason Miller, and he's tremendous. Not much else, though, after him. And I think that we get a situation here where the Astros can get up and just close out with their good guys, Kyle.
Well, I'm talked into it. I was really close. It was the first one I looked at yesterday, and then I ended up going crazy and doing a riskier one, which we'll talk about here later in the show. But for purposes of the show, the guys have talked me into it. Corby's locking in the Astros first five on the run line. That's at minus 120. I'm going to lemon booty it up in those last four innings and go for the double result at plus 110. Back in Ronel Blanco today. Let's see if he gets 18 outs yet again.